To make a backup of your PowerChurch data, go to Utilities and then choose Backup and Restore Files. Select Backup Files and click Next. Now choose which files you want to backup. You can backup individual modules or all files. Choose the drive that you want to backup to. Older versions of PowerChurch will only allow you to backup to removable devices like CD, zip disk, or floppy disk. Newer versions of the program have this folder option. This lets you browse to any location on your computer, including local drives, external drives, flash drives, and even network locations. You can also add the backup routine in PowerChurch Plus to scheduled tasks in Windows. Unfortunately, this feature is only available for the desktop version of PowerChurch, and not PowerChurch Online. To do this, go to File, Preferences, and System Setup. Click on the Backup tab. There you can specify where you want to save the backup. Below, you can control the notifications that are sent out by the system. It will send you an email when the backup is complete. Optionally, you can also set it to just receive notifications if there's a problem. The program to add to the scheduled tasks is called pcbackup115.exe. You can find this in the PowerChurch program directory. To restore a backup, go to Utilities and choose Backup and Restore Files. Select Restore Files and click Next. It's important to note that restoring a backup permanently overwrites the data in PowerChurch with the data contained in the backup file. There's no undo button. So if you aren't certain of the information contained in the backup you're about to restore, it's a good idea to make a new backup prior to restoring one. So choose the drive or folder where your backup file is stored. If there are multiple backups in that location, it'll show you a list and you'll be prompted to choose the backup that you want to restore. The backup's information is shown on the screen and you're able to restore all files or selected files from the backup. Restoring selected files from the backup can cause problems if not all related files are restored together, so it's a good idea for this kind of advanced operation to have a support person available to you when you're doing it. And when the restore process is complete, the data files are re-indexed. Then the program is closed. This forces you to reopen the program and go through any password protection that may have been enabled by restoring the backup.